הרי הראש למעלה בעורף, וצריך לכוון הקציצה שתהיה באמצע כדי שתהיה כנגד בין העיניים. That's one הלכה. Another הלכה that's very important, that's מקום הנחת תפילין של ראש. מההתחלה תיקרא השיער ממצחו. It needs to be over where the hair starts. The hair starts right here, it needs to be above that. It can't be under. And the Mishnah Bura goes on and on to explain how severe this is. He says the following. Makom tfilin, mimakom sheyesh shayachut korcha, where a person could be bald. And that is where the hair starts. Dainu makom atchalat tzmichat ha-sarot shebarosh. Rabim nichshalim b'isur ze. Many people are violating this isur. Ve'toim lomar shakateh lo matchil makom ha-sar, v'ikar tfilin munach al ha-metzach. The tfilin goes down to the forehead, it goes down like this. The tefillin goes down to the forehead like this. He says, "Ovrim al isur deoraita." It goes a little bit down under the hairline, the violating isur deoraita. Kol tefillin tzichim liot munachim b'makom sheyesh korcha. The entire tefillin must be b'makom that a person has hair. Shehayinu sheyafilu k'tzeh ha'tachton shel ha'titur ha'munach al makom hatchalat ikar ha'se'arot. Aval ויותר טוב להניח קצת למעלה משיעור זה. משנה ברורה also says that one should put it a little bit higher than where the hair starts. So don't worry about it if it's not right there. Higher is better in order that if it goes down a little bit, it's still in the right place. And don't worry about the fact that it might be very high, because really in reality he says that you could put two tefillin, one on top of the other. So you see that if it's high like this also, since it's placed in the head for two tefillin, that's good enough. Kol amaniach al ha-metzach. If a person puts it like this on the forehead, hu minhag karaim. This is the minhag of the karaim. Ve lo asa mitzvah. He didn't do a mitzvah. Before he told us also that he violated the isur d'oraita. Vechol ba nefesh erzhir lechaverav. Every person should warn his friends and tell them that this is the wrong way. Ve lamdem shelo yikashlu beze. Kele shelo yuchas shalom bichlal poshei Yisrael begufan. Now you need to understand very quickly that there is a concept called Poshei Yisrael Begufan. And that means that there's a certain level that if a person is on the boundary of going to Gan Eden or Gehenom, this mitzvah of tefillin, the Gemara says in Rosh Hashanah Yud Zayin, would determine, would he go here or would he go there? It's called Poshei Yisrael Begufan. Karkafta de lo manach tefillin. If a person didn't put tefillin, there are opinions that even if one time the person didn't put the tefillin, he's already poshe Israel begufan, and he needs to do teshuvah and fix that. And this is something that's very severe, and a person that puts the tefillin like this, and he says, oh, it's hard for me, it's this, it falls down, that's not an excuse, because he didn't put the tefillin, he wasn't yotzei, he violated isur d'oraita, it's minat karaim, he could be for Ashkenazim, made a viracha levatala, because they make bracha on the shel rosh. And therefore, a person needs to fix it right away when this happened. Fix it right away, put it right in the right place. If it's too big, fix the kesher. Give it to the rabbi, make sure that he makes it a little bit smaller. Chazak v'ruch.